And today we're going to be talking about Doom 4 Beta.
The are they still beta. Calling it 4 though? Or
no, it's Doom. It's Doom.
It's Doom.
It's Doom.
They're trying to confuse everyone.
Damn. Alright, then let's talk about Doom and how Doom is.
So did you play the open beta?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
No.
Why not?
Okay. I don't know how it is on the console, but on the PC it's very sluggish.
It's sluggish.
Yeah, and I had put my mouse on high sensitivity.
Okay.
High DPI. But when I was moving, it was still a little bit slow than what I was comfortable with.
Okay.
I mean, I assumed that the game would be kind of similar to Unreal, at least in the movement. But no. The whole double jump thing, it just reminded me of Halo too much.
Is it faster than COD at least?
COD? No.
It's not faster than Call of Duty?
I don't think so. Call of Duty is a lot more hectic. This seemed fine. In Call of Duty, everyone kills me.
Okay.
If I get one kill, I'd be lucky. In this,
it's too easy for you?
It's not just easy, it's just... I just feel that even the other people are not that... you can't really move that much. It's too sluggish.
So you don't like the movement and what...
Yeah, I'm not very happy with the movement. Sure, I like the part where if you jump on a ledge, he climbs up like Far Cry. But then...
Oh my god, okay, is there anything that's very original? Because all I can hear is Halo.
The game is original. And yeah, even the loadout is very similar to Call of Duty.
Call of Duty.
Which kind of defeats the purpose of a Doom game, because Doom may use to pick up weapons rather than
have
a loadout. How was it on the console though?
I liked it. I've played a lot of Unreal. Yeah. And I used to play it primarily on PC.
Hmm.
So when I heard that Doom was coming to consoles, I was kind of happy thinking, okay, now console players will have something similar to Unreal to play on your console. But that sadly is not the case with Doom, because it's not fully Doom and it's not fully Call of Duty, it's somewhere in between.
Okay.
And I'm happy for the console. I mean, I play primarily on consoles, and I'm happy for the console players who haven't played Unreal or anything, and this is a good entry into an arena shooter.
Yeah.
Alright.
As to how, because of the loadouts, it's easy for like Call of Duty players to get into it. But because I played Unreal a lot, so even though I was excited for Doom, and even though there isn't a good arena shooter on the console, it didn't feel like a frantic arena shooter. That's one of the... It starts right at the loadout.
Yeah.
And it has a lot of issues in between. So the loadout is bad, because it was fun to learn the map, know where the weapons are, and
yeah.
You know, chase. I mean, so how it used to be was there would be a big map, and you started off with a melee weapon.
Okay.
So, and then you went around finding your pistol, then you went on to find a shotgun, a assault rifle,
a minigun,
a rocket
launcher.
And then finally there would be like one really epic weapon that can like one shot like 10 people at a time. Unreal, like there was a big...
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense that they may not didn't put this because it's too similar to Unreal, but I don't know.
But didn't Doom and Quake have all of that already?
Yeah, I mean, they did.
I mean, it was there anyway. So
yeah, it was a thing.
Yeah, do it that way.
Yeah.
And also another big thing that I'm noticing it because I played like Unreal on PC and I'm playing Doom on console. I mean, I'm happy for console players who have no idea as to what they're missing out. Then
yeah,
this game is perfect for them.
Okay.
Yeah. Like there were moments, since I know how the it's supposed to feel, so I was trying to get on some ledges that you don't have to get onto, and jumping from that ledge to another ledge, which is again not meant to get onto, it serves no real purpose other than you get a good vantage point.
Yeah.
But then I felt that these moments are meant for the PC. It's not supposed to be done so well on a console, and that just put me off. Because I enjoyed like the wall running, the side jumping and all of that in Unreal, and all that was smooth because he used a keyboard and mouse.
Yeah.
It's not there on
the console.
Yeah. I still felt it's more fast paced and front. For me it was more faster than Call of Duty.
It seemed too sober for me. I mean, because everyone was just doing their own thing, I guess.
But that's the team deathmatch. I mean, everybody's trying to get their own kills. I think
maybe. But then also, when you get that, what's it called, the demon, right?
The demon.
Yeah. So the demon kind of just makes whichever team gets the demon power, right?
Okay. So let's tell them what the demon is.
Oh, so the demon is tell them.
Okay. So like there are no weapons that you have to pick up, but there's ammo, there's
health,
and there's power ups.
I think there's armor also. Right?
Yes, there's armor.
Yeah.
There is health. There's ammo, and there are
power-ups.
Power-ups like quad damage, like you get 4 times the damage from your weapons for a limited number of time.
Yeah.
And all of these, they spawn and they have a time like 30 seconds or 50 seconds. and they spawn in. And there is one other special pickup, that's a demon rune.
Okay.
So there is this symbol that will be visible to you, and you have to wait for it to spawn. If you pick up that symbol, you become the demon.
Okay.
Which is a very overpowered demon.
It's a very overpowered. I mean, you get like a lot of rocket launchers.
But then again, this is also very similar to Battlefront, where you pick up special characters.
Oh yeah, but...
Like you get to play as Luke Skywalker, you get to play as Darth Vader.
But were you as invincible?
No, you were not as strong, you could still be defeated.
Okay.
But in the demon, it just gives you unnecessary power. Like, it'll just shift the whole game, whole
yeah.
dynamics of the game.
Okay.
So, suppose you're in the blue team, and the red team is, and the red team is losing, right? So, as soon as the red team gets the demon power, probability is the red team will win. Because you'll get that
yeah.
many...
Mm.
And I think with the demon, it's one hit per kill.
One hit kills. Yeah, it's mostly a one hit kill, and the demon also has a huge amount of health. So it's very hard to take. Because every time I became the demon, I ended the round
yeah.
with that demon, and nobody could take me down. And even if I didn't end the round, nobody killed me as a demon. My counter always ended.
I
went back to being a regular.
Yeah,
demon.
I don't think I haven't witnessed a demon death in this game yet.
Yeah, I think I did for the opposite team, like we kind of, somebody in my team killed this idol.
It's rare.
Yeah, it's a little rare.
Yeah.
It's not bad, but the demon rune is bad in the team deathmatch.
Yeah.
The other mode, there's another mode that you could try in the beta, the war path or something like that.
Mm.
So in that there is a moving checkpoint, the checkpoint keeps moving, like like in Team Fortress.
We play the same thing in Call of Duty.
This sounds a lot like Call of Duty, by the way.
You have to stay in one position for like a minute or something.
Oh, not like that.
It's not like that.
So in Call of Duty, the checkpoint like rotates,
changes,
right?
Yeah.
Like it's a point A, then point B.
Yeah.
This thing, it's like moving the whole time. It's like it's moving from point A to point B.
Uh-huh.
So whoever has control, like whoever is able to stay in the checkpoint in the zone,
yeah.
for like a longer time, takes the lead.
Right.
So the good thing about it, about that is that it focuses the action to one point, so everybody knows ki where everyone is,
right.
and it brings the action together.
Yeah,
and
which is cool. Which
yeah,
is something
which
is, original.
Yeah, it, and that's pretty good. And in there, the demon rune is good because if like somebody is losing, they can use the demon rune, get an advantage for a little bit of time. And also, since everybody is together, the team can come together to beat the demon.
Mm.
But in a regular team deathmatch, when everybody is
scattered
around.
Yeah, in that time the demon just goes, picks everybody off, and that's it.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the problem with the demon rune. It's good in some modes, it's not in the other modes.
So, yeah. So moving on from the gameplay and how it has been, from what I've understood is that it has a lot of similarity with, say, Halo, Call of Duty.
Okay, so the reason for that, the similarities with Halo and Call of Duty, is because the multiplayer part of Doom,
was made by the same
guys. It's made by the same guys. I think it's some team world affinity or something.
Yeah, affinity.
Affinity, yeah. Some
but then earlier they were like already, people were already complaining about the fact that it was a lot like, these guys were only complaining about the fact that Doom was a lot like Call of Duty.
Yeah, so Bethesda had already, what they did was they had must have been working on it, and they found out that it was too similar to Call of Duty, so they were like, nah.
So they delayed it.
They cancelled it.
Okay.
To
cancel
hire
it.
People.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess they may have delayed it. But they delayed it quite a bit because I think the game went into development in 2008-2009.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, it was too similar to Call of Duty then. I guess they hired new people and made it way too much similar to Call of Duty, I guess, later on.
Yeah, they hired the same guys and...
Yeah.
Even if you look at the armor and everything, like, it's very similar to Halo's armor.
Yeah,
exactly.
It's very similar.
Especially if you painted it all green.
Yeah, and all the Spartan armors, even the
helmet,
the helmets and everything, they look very similar. I don't know if that's coincidental or intentional, because Doom Marine's armor was anyways kind of like the Halo.
It was kind of similar, but it was like half sleeves in the original game.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I haven't played much of the original Doom, so I don't remember that.
I don't
mind the armor. They look good.
Yeah, it looked good. The only thing was that. So, okay, we're just judging the multiplayer, maybe the gameplay, the main mission, story mission may be good.
Yeah,
maybe.
They may be, because like Bethesda has made Fallout, which Fallout 4 wasn't the best for me.
But Fallout 3 was...
3 was good, and not even 3, like they made new games like Dishonored, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
I mean, even though they had another studio working with them, Arkane Studios, and they also have Wolfenstein.
Yeah.
Which
was actually pretty good. Wolfenstein, Bad Blood. So.
Bad Blood and...
there was another one.
There were two of them, but
yeah.
Both of them were pretty good.
Both of them were really fun. And both of them are really underrated games.
Yeah. But people like them. Whoever's played
them... Yeah,
there
was no negative feedback for those games. Yeah,
they weren't
so,
very hyped up, though.
Yeah.
They weren't
very hyped up.
Yeah, but I myself have heard good...
Yeah, good stuff about
that. I just hope the new Doom game doesn't reboot the whole franchise. I wanted to add to it when it comes to the story.
Okay. Well, I wouldn't mind a reboot because I haven't played much of the earlier Dooms.
I guess, but actually, you should play the earlier Dooms because every decade there's something new that comes out that changes the whole way you play a game.
Okay.
And Doom was that.
Okay.
I think even I haven't played the game, but I've definitely seen like my brothers grow up playing Doom, and it's always been something that's always fascinated me.
Yeah.
So Doom, I know, is something. It's like a classic for all.
Very classic genre-defining shooter.
Yes, absolutely.
It's a granddaddy of all shooters.
Yeah.
So that's the funny thing. I mean, it being the granddaddy of all these shooters, why is it trying to learn
copy,
things? From,
learn things
from them. They learn from you. So you teach them something new now.
So going on to something new, how are the graphics this time? Let's start with PC.
Yeah, let's talk about PC first.
So I saw the graphics on the PC and the PS4. I didn't notice much difference.
Okay.
Right.
Actually, I didn't really notice any difference.
But then again, I've heard that the advanced settings have been locked down for now.
Yeah, they have.
They've created.
I couldn't change anything in the advanced. I mean, I couldn't access it actually.
Yeah. So maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Because right now I've heard it's locked at 60 FPS. But they'll unlock it. They'll
still
unlock it.
I don't know. At 60 FPS also, it doesn't feel too much like 60 FPS.
Okay.
Maybe only because the controlling of it on the PC was a bit sluggish.
Okay.
For me at least.
Right.
As far as consoles, the game was fast.
Yeah.
I have to admit, I won't say the game wasn't fast, but that's for consoles.
Yeah.
The same, I mean, I still do remember that Unreal is a lot faster. That's why I think Unreal is free anyways on the PC. So Doom isn't bringing anything new to the PC unless it does something really dynamic and amazing with the campaign.
Yeah, exactly.
The
campaign is
kind
of what I'm waiting for.
Yeah.
And so I won't touch the game right now.
Yeah.
I'll play the campaign and then maybe.
Yeah, the campaign will tell if the game is good or not.
Yeah.
Because for multiplayer, PC already has good, really good arena shooters already.
Yeah.
And Unreal is like...
Unreal Tournament is Unreal.
I mean,
Unreal
in my game
just came out.
Yeah.
I think still in alpha though, right?
It's still in alpha, but it's still... The completed maps are pretty polished and the game is awesome. It's as good as Unreal ever was.
Yeah. When graphics are concerned, I don't know, I wasn't incredibly impressed by the graphics. Also, not for the PC, but I'm not talking about the PC graphics, I'm talking about the console graphics.
Okay.
I wasn't really that impressed because I've seen those kind of graphics before on older games.
Okay.
So, I don't know, it didn't make it more edgier. I would prefer graphics from like Unreal Tournament, which is a lot more edgy.
Yeah, but then Unreal has a different look to it because Unreal is a little more flashy and colorful, and Doom is a little more.
I guess, but
I
didn't mind the colors and all because that's Doom for you, right? I mean, it's all demons and shit like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean the graphics. I mean, I wasn't really impressed. But then again, I wasn't exactly impressed by Fallout 4's graphics.
Okay,
so that's a fantastic game.
Yeah, but Dishonored is pretty good.
Dishonored is good, then...
Wolfenstein? I don't know.
Wolfenstein is also pretty good, actually, for that time.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just feel that from what all I've heard and what all I've read, as well as the reviews on Steam, everywhere else, is that...
they're very divisive.
Yeah, like, most of them, like, on the reviews on Steam are very negative, per se. But I want to ask you guys this one question, that would you guys actually spend that much to get a Doom?
May see the reviews first once the game comes out.
Yeah.
I mean, if you get a free game copy.
A review copy,
I'll play it. But I'll wait for the reviews of the game, of the campaign reviews, not the multiplayer reviews. Because, I mean, I'm more of a campaign guy, I need story. I don't play a lot of multiplayer as well. Division is there, which I kind of stopped playing it also.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if the story is good, then I may actually buy the game.
So what about you,
Manus? I also probably wouldn't buy it for the multiplayer.
Yeah.
Not for the multiplayer.
Yeah.
Unless they actually change. But then the game's about to come out.
Yeah, it's about to come out. Like,
I mean, I don't know how much they can
four,
change at this point.
That's what.
Weeks, right?
I mean, this is basically a playable demo.
There's also more stuff in the game. Like, did you try any of the secondary fire modes?
What are the different modes?
I
Like, one is the primary mode, right?
No,
like,
I did, yeah.
It
was...
Most of the secondary fire modes, and this is really odd. Like, some of them have, like, some special firing stuff.
Mechanisms.
Most of them, it's just, you get to zoom.
Yeah.
Like,
hey,
this is
you know
Doom.
What? I give
you
an opportunity to zoom.
But this is Doom. You don't stand in one place and zoom at your enemy. If you stand in one place, you're dead.
Yeah.
And most of these weapons have a secondary secondary mode, and that is a zoom. Why are we zooming? This is Doom. And also another thing that I...
Why are we zooming? This is Doom.
Yeah. And another thing that I really noticed, which is like in Unreal and everything, you start off with a very simple melee weapon and then you go...
Yeah.
There is no default melee weapon in this game. You
yeah.
hit with your gun.
Yeah, you could just hit with your gun.
It just looks so Call of Duty or...
Like, it's just like bam, bam.
Yeah.
Like normal melee attacks.
And of course, if you like bring the head down and you do a melee...
I like the gold kills.
Yeah, the glory kills.
The glory kills,
yeah.
Sorry, yeah.
They look pretty cool.
Those are satisfying.
Yeah. And I like them.
Yeah.
I've heard complaints about them, but I like them.
I mean, I like them, but I don't know. I'm not sold on them because it's too much like... Apna Gears of War again.
Okay.
Like the way you
yeah.
go through the chainsaw, right?
Yeah.
It's pretty much the same feel. You just hold the head and just...
Just looks cool.
Yeah, it looks cool. I won't
that
lie.
That sounds cool though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One time this happened to me. I went for a kill, glory kill. Yeah, the thing is, glory kills are tough to come by though. You have to be at the right... You have to be at the right spot at the right time.
Yeah.
Oh,
so,
I don't know I don't know the exact requirements to
yeah,
put off a glory kill.
So I didn't know at that time, I didn't know you need low health. So I just go to a guy, glory kill, another guy comes behind me and glory kills me.
Oh.
Shit.
The glory train.
Alright.
What else are we talking? Oh, there's character customization and weapon customization.
Which is cool.
Yeah.
You can make your gun dusty, which is nice.
Yeah, you can like, you can...
You can add scratches, you have patterns.
Yeah.
The
all of that is...
okay.
Yeah.
I mean...
I know that's something you like to do. Like really...
Yeah, I like
but
it.
Yeah. Yeah, we can't have a female character.
Yeah, I mean it's fully covered, so maybe they will, but it's fully covered. It doesn't really,
doesn't
really show anything.
But it's cool that so you can make your right arm different than your left arm.
Yeah,
which is nice. I guess.
I like the customization.
I feel like we're just looking for good things in Doom now.
Yeah.
Like,
no, I don't
customize. कर सकते दोनों हाथों को अलग
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 है. But not the two feet. The two feet.
Yeah,
two
feet
are
the same.
I tried that as well. I like the customization. I'm glad there is the option too.
Yeah.
And even the weapon customizations,
it's
you can
it's
make
nice.
Your weapon look absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's like an optical migraine. It's
oh,
that bad. They look ugly, but at least you can do it and irritate people. So.
I made it pink and orange.
Yeah, that's what I
would go together.
That's what I'm talking about.
Why would you do that?
But another thing is like you can't find weapon pickups,
mm.
and you can't pick up your enemy's weapons either.
Yeah.
Which is odd, even Call of Duty let you do that.
Yeah.
So why would they...
But was
it's...
this the case earlier with Doom? This was the case earlier with Doom. You could
Doom.
In earlier you could pick up everything in your map.
Doom, the original game, you could just pick up anything.
Yeah. This is odd. And it there's also some leveling up. I want...
Yeah, I was like, I don't want to play an RPG.
What is... like, it's again like Call of Duty where you level up and stuff, but...
Yeah. And you level up, you unlock more things. You unlock customization.
Yeah. This
of
is,
loadouts.
This is not
That's...
Doom. That is the problem with Doom.
Yeah, because
Doom.
I mean, all that I've understood in this is that you guys have taken so many names of so many games.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, so what's so special about Doom?
Again, I'm not going to judge it right now. I've already judged the multiplayer. Right now, I'm going to judge the multiplayer, which is not impressive. It's nothing new. I mean, it's all been
yeah.
done before.
It's only a little faster for consoles.
For consoles, not for PC maybe.
Also, there's damage numbers. This time you see damage.
Oh yeah,
numbers.
You see that damage numbers.
But then
it's always clocked at 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. I keep getting 9.
Oh, I got 20. I kept.
Oh, depends where you shoot also. If you shoot in the head, you get.
Maybe it's the weapon.
Yeah.
Maybe it's different weapons
maybe.
Give different numbers.
Yeah.
So, but I didn't mind the damage numbers. It's a little RPG-ish, but you can turn it off if you don't like it. Figure it out. So.
Yeah. But one thing weird was with the rocket launcher.
Mm-hmm.
So if I have the rocket launcher, I'm shooting a guy. If he's standing right in front of me and I shoot him, right, I don't get affected at all from the rocket launcher.
No, there's nothing.
I don't get damaged. Your character will not get damaged. Which is really odd.
There isn't any splash damage like
yeah.
for you. That's odd.
Yeah.
No, but okay.
Like, while I was playing, maybe it may have been a glitch. I doubt it though. There was so I was here, right? An enemy was here. I shot the rocket launcher and it didn't affect me at all. At all. Which was kind of weird.
Yeah, that's a little.
Yeah.
I mean, one
because I've heard
you to get a little more real with you know, the games as they grow.
Yeah.
Right?
And no, this thing was there in the previous games. And also, like, when, if you shoot a rocket launcher at your foot, like, and you could do a jump, like an extra jump, and I've heard, I haven't tried this, but I've heard that's missing and you get damaged.
Okay, I don't know.
That's what somebody told me.
Okay.
Though I haven't tried it, so I can't really say, but I've heard that's the case.
Yeah.
And also, did you try the hack modules?
I gave up after a while.
Okay.
So I just played very little of it, then I wasn't really impressed. I was actually getting bored of it. I decided to close this event after that, right?
Okay. I did like it. I because you have Unreal, I don't, on console.
Probably.
So I wanted to get like as much out of it as I could.
Yeah. Like,
so the hack modules, what they do is, you can like get some boosts. Every time you spawn, you get a boost. Like you get some extra.
Oh yeah, okay, now
you,
I know.
You spawn in with extra armor.
Yeah.
One hack module is a little tricky though. You can see people through walls.
Oh.
So if you get that hack module, you get an advantage. It's not bad. I'm not saying it's bad.
You get a massive advantage though, right?
Yeah, you get an advantage, but it changes how Doom was.
Yeah.
It changes the whole feel.
Feel of it.
That's the whole, like these.
Maybe Doom isn't the Doom that we all remember from our childhood.
Yeah, it probably, which?
Maybe this Doom is an amalgamation of all the rest of the FPS games.
Yeah, it's like Doom is now learning from everyone else and
yeah.
It's trying to be accessible to newer players.
I think
it's also
opening markets to a lot of new players. I mean, that's the only thing I can understand other than the fact that they've totally fucked.
Campaign.
You guys are like really like.
I really
no,
want Doom 3
I'm
well.
Holding on to it.
Yeah.
Doom 3 was especially bad. Doom 3 was especially kind of bad.
Okay,
was supposed to be the reboot of the Bulls franchise.
Oh, okay, so they're trying to start again.
Yeah.
Let go of the numbers in a.
Get John Cormack back, man. That's the original.
That's the guy who made Doom.
Level designer.
Okay.
Get him back. Let him do the thing. Actually, he's still taking on unreleased level designs of the game.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, one recently came out, I think last year or early this year.
Okay.
Which was still pretty cool.
Okay.
I'd rather play that than this.
Oh, is that bad?
I didn't like the multiplayer.
Okay.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah, campaign saves Doom. Because it brings me to the question that, you know, I mean, do people these days even want Doom? Like, I mean, is there a place for Doom? Because, like, we already have Unreal, which is free. We have good campaigns, we have good shooters and good campaigns.
Yeah.
So does Doom even really have a place? I mean, for consoles, I get it.
I think that's the reason why they're making it like...
More accessible.
More accessible
yeah.
to different audiences, because they want to involve different kind of people.
Yeah.
Different kind of players, people who are into RPGs or, you know...
But that's not
yeah.
Doom, I mean, they have followers.
Exactly,
for that.
Exactly. So maybe they're trying to like really stretch Doom in a way, you know, and like you're saying,
cater to a bigger audience.
But
if you see the Steam reviews also, it's mostly negative.
Yeah. And I think most of them are the guys who were excited for Doom, like who was their primary audience.
Yeah.
And well, I hope they get a big audience and it works out for them, because
I think the primary audience is the one who's actually waiting for the beta.
Yeah.
But eventually when people hear that, okay, so this one's out and stuff, let's try this game as well. And
yeah.
there's
maybe
a lot of similarities. Maybe people who play Call of Duty can be like, okay, let me like
yeah, let's play some.
I mean,
yeah.
let's
and I don't mind it because we still have Unreal, so
yeah.
You guys are like totally Unreal, right?
Unreal is a lot more easy to play. It's a lot more faster to play.
Yeah,
it's a lot more hectic.
Yeah,
it's a lot more tense. This was I was just going like, let's go somewhere else. Head space to spawn again. Okay.
Alright guys.
So that's Doom for you.
Yep, that's Doom. And if you guys like this video, and if you guys have more to say about Doom, and give me some gyan, and go ahead, write in our comments, like this video, subscribe to our channel. I think we're going to say bye now. I'm Gunur.
Share this video with your friends.
Yeah, damn it, share it with your friends and make your friends share it with their friends, and then we will all become a huge group of friends and we'll play.
Yes, and share
Unreal tournament
together. Share this video, yes.
Also join the Gaming Central clan on Clash Royale.
Oh yeah.
Shameless, like you're plugging in Clash Royale in Doom.
Dude.
I play more of Clash Royale than I play in Doom.
I don't think you should tell people that.
I played more of Dying Light.
Yeah, that's better.
Yeah, so, yep, like, comment, share, and we'll see you next time. I'm Gurnool.
I'm Manus.
And I'm Nikhil.
Bye-bye.